What we did in the previous lecture was to consider a small example, example of two equations, two linear equations in two unknowns, and then a three equations in three unknowns, and solve that using a Gauss elimination technique. What we did was try to first motivate the Gauss elimination technique by solving the equations naturally. From this point onwards, we will talk about the Gauss elimination technique. I have written down the matrix A and the vector B that we considered in the previous lecture in this matrix form. I have also shown here this lower triangle part of this matrix. We are going to make this lower triangle 0 using the Gauss elimination process. So, what we did was use row 1 in order to get 0s over here and over here. Next, we use row 2 in order to get 0 over here. When we ended up doing when we did that, we ended up with an upper triangular matrix. That means the values above at and above the diagonal may be non-zeros, whereas all the values below the diagonal are definitely going to be equal to 0. Okay. So, that is what the Gauss elimination process is going to lead us to. The first step that we said was R 2 plus minus 2 divided by 1 into R 1 and R 3 plus minus 3 by 1 multiplied by R 1. Okay. What that led us to, the first row does not change. So, we get 1, 1, 1 and 4. The second row, we definitely know that this term is going to be 0, that is through the choice of our alpha 2 1. Okay. So, we do not need to do any computation over there, we will just get 0 at this particular location. This is going to be 1 minus 2, which is minus 1, this is going to be 3 minus 2, which is going to be 1, and this is going to be 7 minus 8, which is minus 1. Okay. This term, again, we know for a fact that this is going to be 0, we do not do this extra computation, we will just put 0 over here. This is going to be 4 minus 2, which is going to be equal to 2. This is this term, sorry, 4 minus 3, not 4 minus 2, sorry, 4 plus minus 3 multiplied by 1. So, 4 minus 3, which is going to be equal to 1. This is minus 2 minus 3, which is going to be minus 5, and 9 minus 12, which is going to be equal to minus 3 over here. Okay, so, this is what we get at the end of step 1, and in step 2 we will have R 3 plus 1 minus of 1 divided by minus 1, okay, minus of this coefficient divided by this particular coefficient, that is what we will have in step 3, and as a result of step 3. We will get this matrix as 1, 1, 1, 4, that remains unchanged, 0, minus 1, 1, minus 1 remains unchanged, and this is the row that will change. This remains unchanged because this guy is 0, so we will not do anything to it. This we know for sure that this value is going to turn to 0, so we do not do this computation, just put that as 0. So, the only computations that we will do is minus 5 plus 1, which is minus 4, and minus 3 minus 1, which is also equal to minus 4. Okay. So, this is the Gauss elimination process. What I will do in each of the steps is all the elements which we have changed through the row operations, I will put them in different colors. Okay. So, we have changed this with row operations, we have changed this with row operations, we have changed this with row operations, 1 minus 5 minus 3 we have changed with row operations, 1 minus 5 minus 3 we have changed with the row operations. This 0 and 0, although we have done the row operations, that row operation was really the computation of this coefficient. We have not done explicit addition over here. So, I will use a third color, the red color, to represent this. Okay. likewise I will use the red color to, okay, sorry, in this particular operation these values are not changed, so I will keep using white over here. Okay, this will, I will use red color because we know for a fact that this guy is going to be 0 after the row operation, so we do not change it, and these have been affected by row operations, so I will put them as yellow colors. Okay, so a few things that we had noted in the previous lecture as well is that Gauss elimination for an n by n matrix it has n minus 1 steps. Okay, n minus 1 steps, in this case it is a 3 by 3 matrix, and in a 3 by 3 matrix we had 2 steps, 3 minus 1 equal to 2 steps. In ith step we do rj plus alpha ji multiplied by ri with j equal to I plus 1 to n. Okay, so in step 1 we will change r I plus 1, that is r 2, r I plus 2, that is r 3, and so on up to r n, in this case n is 3, so we are changing row 2 and row 3. In the second step we will change, in the second step I equal to 2, so j is going from 3 to 3, that means we will do only one row operation, and that is going to be r 3 plus negative of a 3 2 divided by a 2 2 multiplied by r 2. Okay, so that was the row operations, row operation that we did. So this resulted in the lower triangular matrix 1 1 1 4 0 minus 1 1 minus 1 0 0 minus 4 minus 4. Okay,